Hey guys, what's up? It's Exuperst here again, and today I'll be reacting to episode 1 of Kimi Todoke from me to you. So I don't know much about this anime. I only know that it's a romance story, and it started in 2009. There's a second season, and apparently a third season was supposed to come out last year, but it hasn't. It's been delayed for some reason and possibly coming out this year. But yeah, so basically I'm going blind into this reaction. And yeah, I can't wait to see how this story shapes up. So hopefully you guys enjoy it. Hopefully I enjoy watching this show. And yeah, here we go.
やばいんだってよ。3秒以上目が合うと。知ってる?7日後に不幸が来んだよね。そうそう。怖い、怖すぎ。でさ、ゆかも目を合わせて風邪ひいたんだって。
Oh my gosh. Bruh, okay. Okay. Interesting how these rumors actually form, right? Sawako, not Sadako. It's probably her hairstyle, right? Her haircut. I mean, it's probably because of their bias and prejudice. Okay. Seems like a sweet guy. And she seems like a very sweet girl. Well, that's true. It's unfair to her. Okay, I like the way that they're... I don't know if it's going to be the two of them who's going to be paired up later on, but I like the way that it's... Oh my gosh, what? She has actually a close friend.
むしろもう爽やかさからできてますって感じ。
Oh my gosh, what? Interesting how he responded to it. Well, that's how she meant it, right? This guy's smooth. Okay, she's so precious. She needs to be protected. Oh, but it's Kazehaya.
Oh, 少々なんだよ言えよな俺一応幹事なんだからさ来ねえかと思ったじゃんよ
あ言うと風早くんの量を減らしてしまうので
量なんだよそれ一人でこんなとこ怖くねえの
私夜は割と好きなので特に夏の夜は空気とか匂いとか葉っぱの音とか虫の声とか
本当だなんか気持ちいいから俺もここにいていい？
え、でもあの肝試し
誰かさんがいないおかげで人数奇数になって俺一人なんだよね怖えじゃん
Fate.
Yano-san! Yoshida-san!
Are you? Why are you here? You
guys, if you knew, tell me.
Gentlemen. You're
so beautiful. You guys,
really?
Wait, does he like him? Doesn't like her?
You're doing a good job. Let's go. Let's go.
終わった夏休みだ
じゃあ帰る前に肝試しの結果発表な
まず風早罰ゲーム決定だ
ゴールしなかったもんな
やっぱバレてたか
1位は田中商品はたわし60個な
商品的に
そしてビリの風早くんの罰ゲームはなんと
1週間貞子ちゃんと付き合える件です
今なんて
風早昨日貞子と一緒だったんだってな迫られてたんじゃね
いっそくっついちゃえ
あんたらやりすぎだよ
それ以外なら何でもやるよう
わ
おいおい
それが罰ゲームなんて失礼すぎる
OK He makes a point
女の子なのに笑えないこんなん気にすんな
ダメ私かばっちゃダメ風早くんの名誉は誤解です確かに私は昨日風早くんと一緒にいましただけどそれは何も特別なものではなくて風早くんが誰にでも分け隔てなく接してくれる人だからです大丈夫私もう誤解の解き方知ってるただ私が風早くんの優しさや爽やかさ明るさ正直さに惹かれたのは事実でそれだけは何の誤解もありません
Wow.
私は正しいことをしたはず。だけど、やっぱり寂しい。夏休みが明けたら、もう目も合わせないかもしれない。もう、おはようって笑ってくれないかもしれない。避けられるかもしれない。そんなの慣れてたつもりだったのに私あんまり嬉しくて慣れなんて忘れちゃってた風早くに会う前の自分なんてもう忘れちゃったどうして夏休みなのに
これ影の MVP だってみんな謝ってた。
みんなの誤解解けたんだね。私のことかばってくれて、わざわざ持ってきてくれて、口聞いてくれて、
さ、多分黒沼は俺のことをあんま分かってないと思うな。
気を使わないで、和也くんの気持ちはちゃんと分かってる。
分かってないじゃん。ね、期待しちゃってもいいんだよね。夏休みも黒沼に会えるって。あの時、
あのもしかして北幌高校だとしたらあっちです。
ありがとう。あの時感じたあの気持ちが、そのまま大きくなった今のこの気持ちが、いつか君に届くだろうか。
He should just confess to her. Basically, he should just confess to her. I mean, I think it's pretty obvious. The show is telling us that this guy likes her, obviously more than she knows. And because of his kindness, she feels a lot more comfortable, very comfortable around him. So I think you should just go out and date. I mean, come on. I don't think there's any other possible resolution for this than that, right? But I like it. I like this show because it's so lighthearted. It's so chill. You know, and the characters are very lovable. Like, I don't... And I think it might make me cry. It depends, but it has that. Right, so it's got some elements of, you know, of drama. It's more slice of life, just, you know, simply slice of life, romance. It's not really comedy per se, because it's not. I mean, the jokes aren't really over the top. And there aren't really a lot of jokes. It just sort of makes you laugh a bit. But yeah. I really like the way that it started so far. It reminds me a little bit of... I really don't like comparing shows, right? Because I like to appreciate a show for what it is without... referencing or alluding to a different show. But this somewhat reminds me a little bit of Horimiya, just the tone of it, although the characters are a bit different. We have Sawako, who's quiet and I guess you can say aloof, and also just very amicable and amenable. She's very sweet, right? Very sweet and nice. And kind of like very precious. You want to protect her, you know? She's so naive and innocent and just, you know, because she often gets misunderstood by people, you want her to experience... It's like you have this urge to want her to protect her from other people who will probably try to hurt her, but at the same time you would want her to experience all the joys and maybe even the lows of life. You know, just you want her to come out of her shell, and that's Kazehaya and the other girls that we've seen so far, I think will be able to help her with that. I like it so far, this first episode, because of the lighthearted vibe. It seems pretty chill, even though it's a romance. I prefer something like this over something that's a little bit dramatic, right? I don't... And although they're not like right away, because if I would compare this to Horimiya, the only thing that is different, I think, is that that one never didn't really beat around the bush. They just started dating. I don't know, maybe after a few episodes, but the main point of the story is not whether or not they will date, it's how their relationship progresses and grows as time passes by, and how, you know, their bonds with other people in the cast also, or in their friend group also grows. So that's why I like it, because you're not making the point of the story whether or not they're going to become a pair, because it's pretty obvious that they will. It's more freeing that way, and you get to learn more about the characters along the way. Not a lot of drama as well, as I said, because, you know, you're not exactly fighting over someone, but, you know, since they've already gotten together, most of the rest of the story will just be, you know, depictions of ordinary life, like kind of like, you know, the epitome of slice of life. That's what slice of life should be. Anyway, so yeah, that was episode 1 of Kimi ni Todoke, and thank you guys for watching this video, and I hope to see you in the next one.